Ladies and gentlemen, my darling's distractions.
Life finds a way.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to My Darling's Distractions. My name is Luke, and I'm joined, as always, by my lovely wife, Deb. Hello, Deb.
Hey, Luke.
How are you doing tonight?
Good. How are you doing?
I'm doing well. I was just thinking as I came back what I was going to be calling this episode. And it feels like we've just did a voicemails episode.
We did, kind of, at the end of the summer.
And I called those our summer voicemails. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, can I call it our fall voicemails already? Even though it feels like I don't even know if legally we are in fall yet.
Of course we are. It's past September 21st.
Oh, is that how that works?
Mm-hmm.
All right. So legally, this episode is going to be our fall.
Nobody will sue you.
That's right. Nobody's going to sue me. not with this legal defense.
Mm-hmm. Fall, so we can call it the fall voicemails.
Yeah, this is going to be our fall voicemails.
Part one. Because you just never know.
That's right. Mm-hmm. I think, can you call something, just call it that thing, but you don't have to say part one if it's the first one, and you can call the second one part two, and it's mm-hmm. not like, well, why didn't you call the first one part one? Because you just never know. Can we not call it part one?
That's fine.
Okay. There's a part of me that expects, if we mm-hmm. have a part one, that we have to have a voicemail, and I don't want to put that sort of pressure on our dear listeners.
Sure.
I'm
fine with that.
This is the episode where we are going to go back through some of your voicemails we've received since our summer voicemails episode. Yep. If you listen to these voicemails and it makes you think, boy, I just wish I could communicate.
I want to join that party.
I want to communicate with Luke and Deb. You can do the same thing.
And, you know, is there anybody out there that, like, we just don't know personally? If so, give us a call.
Yeah, absolutely. We would love to hear from you.
That would be super fun.
If somehow through the crazy algorithms of, which I should mention, we are now on Amazon Podcasts.
Yeah.
Amazon just launched their podcast service. So now we are also on.
So where can you find us?
All over the place, Deb. We're on Spotify, we're on Apple Podcasts, mm-hmm. basically
Amazon
Google Podcasts, Amazon Podcasts. Mm-hmm. You pull up any podcast
catcher app. MyDarlingsDistractions.net.
Yep, you can go out there. We're right now in a continued long-standing legal battle to get MyDarlingsDistractions.com.
No. We are actually working on it.
Yeah, we're working on it. It's not a legal battle, but there's some work that needs to be done. But I don't even know. This is the funny thing. We've said, do we really need to have another domain? Because the cheap part of me is like, why are we going to buy another domain just to redirect it to our main domain, MyDarlingsDistractions.net?
Yeah, I think my exact words were, we deserve it.
That's what Deb said. Mm-hmm. And what swayed me was thinking, with a name like My Darling's Distractions, I do get nervous that some skeezy site could swoop that up. Mm-hmm. And I would just hate for them to take the traffic away from the very wholesome, family-friendly content of MyDarlingsDistractions.net.
So we're doing it for you guys.
And you incidentally find yourself on MyDarlingsDistractions.com, and it's some sort of grossness. We do not want that for you.
So. But anyway, you can get a hold of us by calling us at 61-AIR-0-VOLT.
Mm-hmm.
Or emailing us at MyDarlingsDistractions@gmail.com.
Nailed it, Deb. Good job.
Yep.
You can also reach out to us on Facebook, Instagram.
Yeah.
That's probably about it.
Twitter, okay. I think we have.
No,
did you delete it?
I think I deleted our Twitter account.
Oh.
I don't even know why.
Yeah, I don't know why either.
Hmm. Anyway.
Were you spring cleaning or something?
Yeah, I was like, we never update this. This is going away. I didn't want anything. Huh. I would rather have less social media than dead social media.
Oh,
how do you feel about that?
You leave room for somebody to swoop in and steal it.
Dang it. Now we're going to have a long, prolonged legal battle versus...
No lawyers were harmed in the taping of this episode.
Yeah, we're going to have a long, prolonged legal battle to get back My Darling's Distractions Twitter account.
Yeah.
Maybe that'll be a whole episode. Anyway, that's good banter. Let's jump into the voicemails. Deb, are you ready for these?
Yeah, this sounds fun.
All right, let's see which darling we have up here. This is our first voicemail here.
Okay.
Hey, Luke and Deb. And My Darling's Distractions. This is Mike from Sioux City, longtime guest, first time caller. And just got to tell you guys, I finished listening to the Moment in Time podcast and thought it was fantastic. I spent the whole day traveling and it was on your anniversary. So I thought, you know what? I'm just going to spend the day with Luke and Deb. And I'm going to share my three moment in time songs that just came to my mind as I was listening to the podcast. The first one is Summer in the City by Love and Spoonful. Because every night when I was a little kid, I would go to sleep listening to the oldies station on the radio. And I can distinctly remember laying in bed, looking out my window and listening to that song.
Me too.
Second one, and Deb, I'm just shocked you didn't have this on your list, is the Jurassic Park theme. Because not only does it transport me back to my best movie-going experience, watching Jurassic Park when I was a kid, but every time I see it, it's like just everything that's great about movies, that's what it makes me think of.
Yeah.
And my last one is Make Your Own Kind of Music by the Mamas and the Papas for two reasons. One, it was the opening song of season 2, episode 1 of Lost. When the camera does the slow pan down
so
the hatch.
Creepy.
And you don't know you're in the hatch. And it's like a guy working out, getting up, and that song is playing. And then you realize you're inside the hatch, and it's super freaky. I remember telling Kristen that, my wife, and how it, like, troubled me so much. The next morning, before my alarm goes off, I open my eyes, and I can hear softly playing Make Your Own Kind of Music by the Mamas and the Papas. And I freak out. I quickly realized that Kristen made a CD of that song over and over again and set the sleep timer on the stereo in the living room to go off right before my alarm. And it was one of the greatest all-time pranks she has ever pulled on me. But I just want to share that with you guys. Love the podcast. Keep it coming. And we'll talk to you later. Bye-bye. Oh, and I love you guys.
That's nice.
Oh, that was a classic prank. Yeah. I've heard that story before. Which, and it reminds me because do you remember when I said to you sometime in the last 2 months, I said, we should play that prank on Mike again.
Oh, I guess I do remember that, but I cannot think of how we would have pulled that off.
Well, I was scheming. Like, I was definitely thinking about how we could pull it off, but I forgot. I never followed through on that. Man, I wish I would have. And I just want to point out, he said Mike from Sioux City, but he's lying.
He is lying. That's a dirty liar. Now, I will say, that he was referencing episode 29. That was our moment in time podcast, which you mentioned. So I think he sent that in right on our anniversary. So this is So we got that back in August.
Yeah,
so we're gonna let that one slide.
I will allow it. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but he's living in Texas now, so hoping that's going well. Mm-hmm. And thanks for calling, longtime guest, first time caller.
Yeah. So what would you have done to prank him? I mean, so my thought first of all was
I was scheming. I was like, I honestly had ideas about how we would do it. I can't think of what was the catalyst though, like why I wanted to do it.
Just because you're a dirty prankster.
I think I was like, well, we don't have much time. They're going to be leaving soon. Yes. We need to do this.
Yes. And if there's one thing Deb needed to do before Mike left was to prank him.
Well, yes. That would have made my day.
The one thing. Mm-hmm. All right. Thank you very much, Mike.
Wait, are we done?
Oh, do you have more to say about those?
Let's see. He also said, the hot town Summer in the City. Mm-hmm. He's like his memory of looking out the window in the summertime. I have that same memory.
Yeah.
I love that he listened to the oldies station falling asleep. That was my life too. And that song. Yeah. I have that same memory. Dun, and I just. Dun, 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 dun. Dun. Nice. Yes. Hot town. And that's just a funny song for me too. I have a memory of my brother. Like, we were on vacation in Chicago or something like that as a family, just walking around. It was an evening in the summertime and he started singing that song. Mm.
And you're like,
it is a hot town. It is
summer in the city.
Yes, it is summer in the city.
Nice.
Hot town, summer in the city. Back of my neck getting dirt and gritty. Been down, isn't it a pity? Doesn't seem to be a shadow in the city. All around, people looking half dead, walking on the sidewalk harder than a match head. But now it's different.
And I'm sure Jurassic Park. I think that actually did come up, maybe. I think we jumped over that. Like, basically tons of movie scores could be a moment in time podcast. You almost have to disqualify them.
Yeah.
Same thing. I disqualify a lot of video game soundtracks.
So that's true.
I would just, that's what would be all of mine.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yep.
All right. Thank you very much, Mike.
Thanks, Mike.
For the voicemail. All right. Next up.
Hey, my darling's distractions. This is M. Roush from S. Falls. Listening to Luke describe basically getting his finger macheted. And he makes the distinction I don't know what you were trying to prove, Luke. You make the distinction that the mower cut your finger, that you didn't cut your finger. But pretty sure the mower didn't come after you and try to take off your finger. Pretty sure you reached into its home and then it was defending itself against you. So I think it is just as accurate to say you cut your finger. It's just that you weren't holding the blade. The mower was. It was just acting in its own best interest. I love you.
Yeah.
I mean, that's just what a mower does. It cuts. You can't change.
I know. As I was just remembering the memory, it's kind of visceral still in my head.
Mm-hmm.
Is like I had to look past. I had to literally lift up a flap that showed a picture of some cartoon fingers being lopped off, and I had to like lift up that flap to be able to put my hands under there to get to where I was trying to get to.
They were like, "Do you really want to do this?"
Yeah, I know. It's like, I'm going to cut off your fingers if you do this. Do you want to do this?
Are you sure?
And anyway, so just an update, a finger update. Fall,
yes, please.
All right, everybody, this is get ready for fall finger update 2020.
Mm-hmm.
And my finger's doing well.
That's it.
No, yeah, it is. I mean, yeah. My nail's growing back in kind of a weird way. It kind of had to, like, it's not quite as long as it should be.
Yeah. Do you think it'll ever, like, really grow?
I don't know. That part of the nail bed, I don't think it's part of a nail bed anymore. I don't think it's actually part
of... They severed it?
Yeah, I think that part is done for.
Mm-hmm.
It's okay. It still doesn't feel like great to touch it. Like it's the nerves are all screwed up.
Yeah.
I talked to my dad who said that he did a similar thing. He put a drill bit, like he was drilling something and put the drill bit right through his thumb. Drilled right through his nail on his thumb.
Gross.
And did a very similar thing. I think my sister was there at the time. And so he had to like the same thing, like tell his daughter, like, hey, I'm going to need you to like go get help, basically.
She's come to the rescue for you and him.
Yeah, that's right. But with that situation, he said, just a heads up, it's starting to feel better. He said to me 20 years after the incident.
Wow.
So I'm thinking this slight amount of pain may be with me, which I will absolutely accept as my penance for sticking my hand in a mower and not losing a finger.
You've still got that finger. So
still
that's
got the
wonderful.
Finger. I can still type. I can still, it's usable. Ugh. And I can lift things. It's great. It's great. So anyway, thank you
for
your concern.
We'll ask you again in 20 years.
That's right. Thank you for your concern, Miles. I could really, it wasn't, you didn't say anything that showed that you're concerned about my finger in that, but I could sense it in your voice.
Yeah, so I could too. Because he said, I love you.
He did. I think that's definitely what that was about. All right, next up.
Hi, friends. This is Deborah. I'm going to see you in a few hours, but I also just listened to your most recent episode, your anniversary. I am certain your wedding was a beautiful day. I had an idea. You should do an episode on a question about your wedding, and then both Luke and Deb answer it.
No.
You know, details, colors, flowers, things like that. It would be a learning episode. I also realize that if you can't answer questions, it might make you look bad, but that's okay. We still love you, and you're still friends, and even if you don't invite friends to your wedding, they're still your friends. Anyway, episode idea, and can't wait to see you guys. Okay, bye-bye. Love you.
Everyone is really pouring on the love. It's really fun, but she was really pouring it on thick.
Yeah, she was.
I loved it, though.
So the beauty of this being a podcast and not a video format is you can't see how big my eyes got with the idea of us possibly needing...
Recounting details.
I don't know. I think I would hold my own because I don't think I went into our wedding being like, hands off, this is your business.
Right.
Like, I think we definitely like...
There was nothing spectacular about it. I mean, like, you could say we did this.
That's true.
You would be right because really wasn't out of the ordinary.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, we were very, I think, practical maybe is the right word about our wedding. We were just like, we wanted these people to be involved, so we invited them. We talked... We talked through all of those details.
I said, do you want to invite your friends? And you said, no.
I don't remember that conversation. But anyway, so Deb, all right, we'll do a mini quiz. Okay. I'll think of a question, you think of a question.
Okay.
D- Deb,
mm-hmm.
What were our wedding colors?
Oh, black and champagne.
You are correct, Deb. It was black and champagne.
Did you even know that?
Oh, yeah, because oh, okay. I had to, when I created our GeoCities or whatever website for our wedding,
yeah.
I had to come up, I had to get a champagne background with black text.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Yeah, I remember we pointed people to something like Luke and Deb at GeoCities or Luke and Deb yeah. at angelfire.com or yeah. whatever it was.
Which doesn't exist anymore.
I know. I've been actually looking for old GeoCities sites that I've created in the past. I've been trying to hunt them down. It's just really hard to find them because mine are so yeah. generic. And yeah, we actually had a message board. I mean, this was
yeah.
before either of us were on social media. And mm-hmm. so we just, our website, we created a message board and we got a lot of messages from your family specifically. Like I think
in almost, college friends.
Yeah. In college friends. Yeah. Uh-huh. I think almost every, like a lot of the people we knew got on our message board. But that
yeah,
is
but that's
totally
weird to
gone.
Think about. Yeah. Like,
totally gone.
I think Facebook existed, but we weren't
no,
on it.
No, I don't think we were.
And yeah.
2004.
It was like a year later though that mm-hmm. we were.
Mm-hmm. All right, Deb, what's my question?
Did we or did we not have a handout at the wedding?
By handout, do you mean bubbles?
No.
Oh.
I mean paper okay. handout.
Oh, yes, we did.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Can you describe it?
Yeah, it was champagne colored paper yeah. with gold speckles.
yeah.
That was an 8.5 by 11 sheet cut in half. So it was
mm-hmm.
long ways with two holes, paper hole punched in the top, and then a
black
lace
ribbon.
Black ribbon kind of woven
wow, this
between
is really
those
detailed.
And then tied at the top. I know because yeah. I think I tied I tied a lot of those, mm-hmm. helped cut those. Also, I think we used that gold paper for a long time afterwards.
For a really long time. We had a whole ream or two
yes.
and didn't need it all.
Yeah, we just bought a ream of speckled gold paper.
I mean,
it was such an inexpensive, simple wedding.
Like, but I do think that if and when our kids get married, I'm going to encourage them to spend a little bit more money.
Sure.
Yeah. Treat their guests a little bit better.
Yeah, that's right.
So Deborah, like, actually maybe be happy you weren't there.
That's right. I mean, everybody who came got, I feel like they got, I was working at Sam's Club at the time, so I think I bought, like, packages of
this
M&Ms.
This surprises no one.
Packages of M&Ms, mm-hmm. mixed nuts, and yeah. then we paid somebody, to like Hy-Vee or somebody, to make the cake. Or
No, it was a local okay, yeah. person that did that for a long time.
But anyway,
yeah.
So though, I mean, yeah.
No dinner, no dance. Everything was just at one venue, and it was fine. Like,
it was pretty short. So, I mean, if you like shorter weddings, I mean, even like with reception included, it was.
I think the part that we feel the worst about, it was fine. Everything yeah, was fine, great. But we feel the worst about. We took pictures after the ceremony,
right.
and so our guests just kind of waited around
with just M&Ms,
and that's
mixed
all they,
nuts.
They. There was no dinner, no appetizers. Like we yep. felt really bad.
So it's just people milling around the room while we did,
and we're taking pictures. People are leaving.
Oh,
like
ugh, that's anxiety. That's like nightmare fuel.
Oh, I know.
For me.
I don't like thinking about
it. Let's stop talking about it.
Deborah, thanks for bringing that up.
Deborah, we appreciate the voicemail. I do not appreciate the memories you just made me experience.
Why do we like not like thinking about our wedding day?
I like, there's a lot I like about our wedding day.
Yeah.
I'm just saying like there are parts that are just like, ugh.
I know.
Anyway. Thank you, Deborah.
We can do it differently when our kids get married. Yes.
Yeah. Okay. There we go. All right. Here we go. Next voicemail.
Hey, my darlings, distractions. This is M. Isles R. Ausch from S. U. F. Alls calling in because not really commenting on something from an episode, but something you said. Luke, you were calling out sheeple and yelling, actually, quite a bit about sheeple. And that reminded me, I was just in the Watertown area, Watertown, S. Dakota, not long ago, and I was at a gas station and donned my mask before going inside, being conscientious and also self-protective. Mm-hmm. And there was a truck parked in the parking lot of the convenience store and kind of painted with window paint, and several of the windows were slogans that were decidedly anti-mask slogans. Included the phrasing, masks are for sheeple, which made me think of it, and suckers wear masks on another window. But what lost all credibility for me, not that this person was making a compelling argument,
But what lost all credibility for me was the fact that every plural word had an apostrophe in it, making it grammatically nonsensical. Mm. So don't think I will be taking personal health and hygiene advice from that person.
Yeah. Agreed.
Bye.
Surprised he snuck up on you with that one.
I thought I was going to hear, I love you. It was just this like loud bye. Oh, man. No, he had me at grammar errors, and that was the end of it. I mean, not that I was buying these messages from this man.
But the thing is, as a person who often makes grammatical mistakes, I can estimate, but I don't think I would make these, like every plural, just putting apostrophe, like every time you have
an S. I have a student that does that. Every time there's an S on the end of a word, he puts an apostrophe.
Now, to be fair, your student is in third grade.
Yep.
So this person may have also third grade education as far as apostrophes go.
Could be.
Yeah. Yeah, word crimes. Am I right?
Yeah, we got to play a little. That's the best Weird Al song. Like, I'll just say that. I love it so much.
We just recently again re-listened to Weird Al's Word Crimes.
So we were coming back from, it was Labor Day weekend, and we decided to go to Effigy Mounds National Monument.
Yeah.
And on the east side of the state. Mm-hmm. And on our way back home, it was like bordering on 9 o'clock, 9:30, 10 o'clock, 10:30, and Luke decides to play Weird Al for 2 hours.
I know, I had so much road ahead of me, and it was, we weren't going to get home until like 11:30, and I'm like, I need Weird Al to make it through this.
Yeah, you're like, I don't care what anybody else thinks. Mm-hmm. Basically, it was just me. I was the only other one listening.
Yeah.
I checked out, though.
Yeah, you did. I think you might have just like put your head down.
Mm-hmm.
Like,
whatever. Show the world you're no clown. Say you got an IT, followed by a apostrophe. Yes, now what does that mean? You would not use this in this case as a possessive. No. It's a contraction. What's a contraction? Well, it's the shortening of a word or group of words by omission of a single letter. I did like that song.
Yes. Thank you, Miles. Thanks, Miles. Thank you for sharing those word crimes. Yes. All right. Next voicemail.
Hey, darlings, distractions. It's Holly from South Dakota. I am in the middle of your voicemail episode and felt the need to pause the podcast and call in because you guys are at the point where you are talking about your bathroom cleaning schedule. And I don't think I've heard anything more relatable than this conversation happening right now. the kids' bathroom getting cleaned more often, mm-hmm. public facing,
right?
But also still not enough. and the master bathroom rarely getting cleaned because mm-hmm. who cares?
Right.
Deb's stuff overflowing and then purchasing things to contain the overflow and it continues to spread is my life. And I also want to tell Luke that if he is capable of cleaning his own sink, he's capable of moving things around to clean the rest of the bath. So I believe in you, Luke. Mm-hmm. You can do it. Just move stuff around. And then move back. Okay, bye.
Bye.
Holly, I will say you are absolutely correct. There's a part of me that feels like it's the biggest cop-out in the world to be like, Deb's flattening iron is there. I probably shouldn't clean that. It's part of the sink.
Right. I know. I mean, that kind of logic probably spills over into a lot of different areas, don't you think?
Oh, yeah, I'm sure. It's like, I'd be like, I could vacuum the floor, but Deb's shirt is laying on the floor, so I guess I better not vacuum this part.
But I've never felt better than right now. Mm. More vindicated, is that the word I'm looking for?
Sure.
Thank you, Holly, for saying that is your story in your bathroom also. It makes me feel really good. Yeah. And I mean, we both know how to clean a bathroom. That's the thing, is like, I know how to do this.
Oh, yeah.
But it's not urgent.
Yeah, and I think realistically, what I do in my brain is like, I probably do – just the easy clean is like, mm-hmm. all right, like I can grab out a Clorox wipe and wipe down this part of the sink. Cause on my side of the sink, like I said, everything fits in a drawer. Mm-hmm. So it's like, there's nothing there. Just wipe, wipe, wipe. And then like, yeah, I think just the mental, just gymnastics I have to do to be like, all right, am I ready to put like move everything off of the mm-hmm. off of the vanity so I can wipe the whole thing down and then put everything back? Like, it's just, I just, you know, it took so much energy just yeah. to wipe down the a completely uncluttered surface. I think it's that little, that's what I need to overcome. Thank
that
you, Holly.
Hurdle,
yes, thank
hurdle.
You, Holly, for that challenge to start to mentally overcome.
Ooh, I feel better.
Yeah. All right. Let's go on.
Okay.
Hey, you guys. All right, take two. I'm calling from my car, and that distracted me. I didn't done my pattern. Okay. Cut this out. Cut all this out. Hey, my darling's distractions. It's MCR from SFSD giving you a call. Wanted to talk about the, you were discussing, so I'm listening to the clip show, the voicemail extravaganza mm-hmm. episode. So once again, I'm getting caught up on your episodes.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
I'm a little bit behind.
That's cool.
But yes, it sounds like my habits are a lot like Luke's in that I feel like I have to be a completist mm-hmm. for a lot of the media that I consume.
Mm-hmm.
And so if I listen to a podcast or start a new podcast, mm-hmm. I'm getting better about not having to go back and start from the beginning.
Mm.
But there was a time where I would start a podcast and feel like I needed to go to episode one.
Right.
You know, after I decided I liked it
mm-hmm.
to kind of like completely take in everything they have.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And, for sure going forward, I tend to do that. And it's almost a relief for me when one of my favorite but prolific podcasts does a repeat because I know I can skip that episode because I have heard before.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I do the same thing. And then that applies also to email, like Luke was saying.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And I, years and years ago, like in my early days in college, learned about a technique called Inbox Zero.
Goodbye.
All right, I'm going to vent a little bit. You can cut this part out, but the thing cut me off.
No.
And it just beeps, and then it says, goodbye, and then it hangs up on you. It's so unceremonious and cold-hearted the way it cuts off your voicemail.
Oh, I hate that.
So mad. I was in a flow, too.
Oh.
Like, where do I pick up from here, right?
I don't know.
All right. Right. Center myself.
Zero.
Okay.
Yeah. Get back into it.
Anyway, this inbox zero technique is something I still do today.
Uh-huh.
And it's built into tools like Gmail where you can actually snooze an email to deal with later.
Mm.
And so that's what I do. Like if an email comes in, I try to deal with it right away or snooze it for a time when I can deal with it. But I feel uneasy if there are emails in my inbox.
This is worth it, Miles. Thank you.
I need to process them, get them through. I don't like having that hanging over my head.
Yeah.
Stuff I should do, stuff I need to do.
Mm-hmm.
Nope, not for me. All right. Thanks for taking my call twice
mm-hmm.
and putting it together so it's one seamlessly brilliant tirade. And I love you.
Nice.
Oh, I'm really glad he called back.
Mm-hmm.
There was
yeah.
so much more
oh, yeah.
to add to that story.
That's right. Yeah, that's right. I think the cap was, and I still do it today.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I will say.
Maybe I should try that.
Yeah, I will say, I mean, we've talked about this, and I feel like this dirty laundry has been aired on the
yeah.
pod before, is that you are... I think what I would call notorious
yeah.
about having read notifications on your phone that drive me nuts.
I know. It like doesn't bother me anymore, although there are times that I think I should just go through and delete, you know, all of this stuff, but it just takes too long. Yeah.
So like, what's the biggest like notification number you've ever seen on your phone as far as like, you have this many things to take care of like that?
Sure. It's not my current one because like I said, I think it's tapped out. Like, but like, maybe 6,300, like 6,000 something.
6,300 unresolved, yeah. like, alerts.
I don't know. Does it really bother you, the red number?
No. If it were my phone, absolutely. I would, like, be awake. I would, like, do an all-nighter cleaning.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
No way.
Yeah. I mean, the way I do it is exactly what I think the phone companies want me to do, is I touch my phone every 30 minutes to do triage on the last 30 minutes of things that have come up.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
No, I can't do that. Maybe that's it. It's like I go hours and hours and hours through the day that I don't touch my phone, which is why if you text me or phone, like call me, which nobody really does.
Phone you.
If you phone me. If you text me, I have been told I'm kind of hard to get a hold of.
You will end up with the worst notifications, like where they're all of choice, but maybe the healthiest mind out of all of us, because you're not conditioned like I am to like touch your phone every so often. Like it's like a sickness now. I have to touch it and clean it. Like it's getting dirty. It's almost like, you know, like when you wipe down like a piece of glass and it's like you always have to keep it clean. Anyway.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
But I also wanted to make a couple of quick comments on this. And first of all, if you are calling in, there is a 3-minute timer on our voicemails.
Oh yeah.
You are not the first Miles to hit up that 3-minute timer. But usually people will call back and just start the message over and put themselves on a bit of faster clip. Mm-hmm. Miles did not. Needed to share.
He definitely got mad.
Yeah, he needed to share how unceremoniously he was hung up on. So.
And just needed to add that last few seconds, but then he like drew it out for like another minute.
Almost another full 10 minutes.
Really good.
Anyway, if you call in, just a heads up, maybe set yourself a little egg timer. Mm-hmm. You've got 3 minutes on the clock to try to squeeze in your voicemail. Or sometimes just stop talking at 2:50, wait for it to end, and then call back and then just immediately continue your conversation. We don't want to limit you, friends, on what you want to say to us.
Yeah, Luke will splice it together.
Yeah. And lastly, as I will say, is according to this, Miles, I totally agree with you that when I start a new podcast, it's like I need to listen to every single episode. Mm. I need to be up to date. I will sooner get a podcast out of my life if I feel like I can't do it justice than to sporadically listen to a podcast, which is dangerous because I continually grow my podcast library. The only way I'm staying afloat is that some of the podcasts I really enjoy have just stopped making podcasts, which has been kind of a relief too.
Sad.
I just picked up a new one though, that every episode is like 3.5 hours long.
Oh.
And I just started listening to it. It's a actual play D&D podcast, and they have something like 300 and some episodes. Ooh. So you do the math on how many
hours. Are you going to start at the beginning?
I did start at the beginning. I'm like 4 episodes. It's turned into my running podcast. It's what I listen to when I run.
So. Yeah. Okay.
Oof. That one's, but that's kind of my, whenever I run out of podcasts, I always go back and try.
I subscribe to a lot of podcasts that I've never listened to.
I know. I think this is actually the exact conversation.
Is this why we started this?
This is the exact conversation that started
this
voicemail.
We've been there. All right. We've done that.
The snake has eaten its own tail, and we're going to go to the next voicemail.
Okay.
Hi, friends. This is Deborah. I just listened to your latest episode, and I was shocked about your podcast listening style.
Oh.
I thought for sure Luke would be, oh, yeah, just delete it. It's okay. I don't have to watch all the episodes. They're out of date, whatever. And Deb would be, oh, no circles, have to listen, must be on time, all of that. I was shocked. You are the absolute opposite of what I would have decided. But anyway, also, I'm more like Luke in that, and that's crazy. But anyway, my other thought was, it's very Deb to go, but do we really know if you know what's working underneath? And that's what I like about Deb. She always thinks about what could happen, and it's good. So thanks, Deb. Thanks, Luke. And see you very soon. Love ya.
That's funny. I'm really glad that she said it's good. She said it's very Deb and it's good.
I feel like she was obligated to say that.
No, I think she realized that's truthful. Okay. She really does think it's good. I got a message from my sister Paige. She said she was laughing at that exact same thing that I said. And she said, you're such a six.
Right. And there's just like, a little seed of fear that's always lurking, like, what if I do have a bug in my ear?
Yeah. Yeah.
Thank you, Deborah. So those are all about, just a heads up, those are all about our voicemails. Those are all voicemails in regards to our previous voicemails
episode. Yeah. Awesome.
All right. So thank you, everybody. So those are all based on, if you want to go back and hear the context for those, that was back on episode 31.
Mm-hmm.
So, all right. Well, let's jump forward to some voicemails about episode 33. This is the most recent. This was our Muppets episode.
Yay!
All right, so let's jump into those.
Hey, Luke and Deb. It's Holly from Sioux Falls. I am in the middle of the Muppets episode, which is awesome, by the way, so far anyway. And it brought to mind a story that I thought I should share with you. I was like, I don't know, maybe second or third grade, and we got a phone call at the house, and I answered it, and the person on the other line said, this is Jim Hansen, I'm calling for your dad. So I went and brought the phone to dad, told him that Jim Henson was on the phone, and sat there looking at him throughout his entire conversation on the phone, and when he hung up, I basically asked him something to the effect of, like, you know the Muppet guy? You know, my little tiny brain is, like, coming up with all of these connections because my dad does acting and directing and stuff on the side. And I thought perhaps maybe he was going to do something with the Muppets. But no, it was just the high school guidance counselor, Jim Hansen.
Oh, dang it.
And I still remember this story to this day. The other thing about Muppets that I wanted to share too is just how much I love the Menomina, I don't know, reference that seems to be everywhere. At school, we have our classes divided by houses, so that we have like 9th, 10th, 11th, and 12th graders intermixing for just like culture building and such. And so one of our houses, all of our houses are named after the Titans. So one of them is Namazini.
Oh.
And anytime anyone says Menazini, I either in my brain or out loud, start singing Menomina and then like change it to Menazini. 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 So, that's my story, and I love the podcast. Can't wait to listen to the rest of the Muppets one. Might have more to share after that. Okay, bye.
Bye.
Yes, I appreciate that when you're a child, that you assume that your parents, like, very possibly could know Jim Henson and not Jim Hansen. Which,
it's an easy mistake to make.
Yeah, and to be fair, I'm sure that guidance counselor had been like asked, like the Muppets, like I mean, with the name like Jim Hansen.
Yeah, he's heard that before. Yeah, I'm sure
he's heard it before. But I could totally believe your Holly. Small...
Was this before or after you had a pet hot dog?
Oh, dear. I forgot about that.
That's one of my favorite Holly stories. Mm-hmm.
And I will say, I've also am a huge fan of the Menomina. And in fact, I don't know what it was. Our kids, early on, we kind of got them into that. I think I played it for them.
Mm-hmm.
And it was something like, I remember our youngest, who was a little boy at the time, he would like to, Menomina. Menomina. Yes, Holly. I've also been a fan. I was a huge fan of that song. Mm. And so when it got thrown into the very end of The Muppets, the 2000 or the most, one of the more recent Muppet movies, at the very end. So spoilers for the movie, The Muppets.
Yeah.
At the very end, the Jason Siegel.
Sure. Yep.
His character proposes to Amy Adams.
Yeah.
He proposes to her, and she just replies by singing Menomina.
Oh, I remember that now. Yeah. And then it was the whole gang.
The whole gang singing Menomina. It was great. It was a great, 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 great.
That's a good song.
Very funny bit. So thank you for the voicemail, Holly.
Goodbye.
All right, next up.
Luke, it's H. John Benjamin. I'm going to look that up to make sure, but I'm almost positive. Yeah, H. John Benjamin. So the H comes first. Mm. His born name, his given name, his birth Christian name is Harry John Benjamin. Mm. H. John Benjamin. Mm. Typically goes by John Benjamin, I think. I don't think he makes his friends call him H. John Benjamin. Mm.
Probably not.
Or H. John. I would hope not. I don't think he does. I think they just call him John. I think that's what he goes by. I'm sure for the guild, there was already a John Benjamin, so he had to throw on a letter at the beginning there. But that's the name you were looking for. You all agreed on the wrong name, like a bunch of dopes. Sorry, edit that out. Edit out the dopes part. Where I said you all agreed on the same name, and then end it there, and then now pick up. After I say now. Now. Okay. Love the show. Like the host. Okay, edit that part out. I never say I like the show. I never do that part. So, okay, edit that part out. And then when I say now, after now, then edit. Now. Love you. Bye.
Man, I wish you would just stop telling us what to do.
I know. Beauty of this is I'm not doing any of those edits. You guys will all hear I'm not doing any editing.
I can't believe you got it wrong again.
I know.
You always get it wrong.
This is what I have to do is I have to think of some sort of like a weird, you know, like those memory tricks you give yourself. I think the Spanish word for duck is pato. So I imagine a duck inside of a pot every time I think of like, what's the Spanish word for duck?
Oh, okay.
Something along those lines. Mm. So I need to think of something along those lines to help me remember that H. John Benjamin starts off with his an abbreviation or the first letter of his original name and then John.
I would just think, okay, it's opposite of what you think it is. That's what would help me.
But then I'd be like, well, but what do I everybody think it
says,
is?
Everybody says the initial name? For your middle name.
Okay.
But it's not. It's the initial for his first name.
Like Luke A., Mm-hmm. So he's the opposite L. of everybody else. That's right. Oh yeah. So he's just like I'm L. Ardell. He's H.
John.
Got it. H. John Benjamin. Mr. Benjamin, I'm sorry. I know that you listen. Yeah. I know you're a fan.
I expect to hear from him.
That's right. Man, oh man, if we heard from H. John Benjamin, that would just be like I think I'd stop doing the podcast because it would make my day.
Yeah.
Like, well, what do you do after that? Like,
done.
If I could get him to just scream on our podcast. Mm. Maybe he does. What's that service where you can pay celebrities now to give
Cameo?
Cameo. Maybe he's on Cameo. I should look him up. Okay. Well, the next thing we're going to do is we're actually going to jump back to a live voicemail we received during our Muppets episode.
Oh, yeah.
But I held it for this time.
Okay.
So
here we go.
Anyway.
I have a live voicemail.
Oh. Yes. This is a first live voicemail.
Mm-hmm.
Something happened.
Uh-oh.
And I was listening to the last podcast. I think it was in the last one.
Mm-hmm.
And then something happened. And I thought, I need to leave a voicemail about this. And I didn't get around to it. You know how it goes.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. This is rare. So get ready, Luke.
I can't wait.
This is a defense of Luke.
Oh,
wow.
Yeah.
Okay. What is now? I feel like I did something
I'm
wrong.
I'm sitting in accepting position right now.
I don't think it's...
Hands are open.
I don't think it's you.
Okay, all right.
I think it's other listeners. So this is like to my fellow listeners, I just have to say, don't knock popcorn with milk until you've tried it. Mike is booing. I really feel like there's been some hate on popcorn and milk, which I used to strongly participate in.
Yes. Mm-hmm, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But then I tried it and I definitely did not love it.
Sure.
Didn't love it.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
But I think it has its place. Mm-hmm. And I think we need to just let the man enjoy what he enjoys.
I'm not walking into your guys' houses forcing popcorn nor milk down anybody's mouth.
It's right, true. Right. It's except true. Our kids.
No, I have never, to be fair, this is how children work, is they just watch you do something and then they start doing it. But I never suggested to my kids, like, oh, would you guys should try popcorn and milk.
It's true, you haven't
they
forced just, them.
They did watch me do that for like 8 years, and now they've chosen to follow my footsteps. But thank you for that defense.
Yeah. I just had to say, just try it. I felt like I didn't love it, but I understood it.
Yeah, there we go.
Okay.
And after I listened to your guys' last podcast, I was having popcorn as a snack.
Did you get out the milk?
A little salty. And almost like, I went and got the milk.
And you're like, just a little drink of milk.
Almond milk. It was a delight.
Yeah.
Give it a chance.
A little too salty. You need to calm it down.
I've never tried it. So I just always, I know.
I know. Deb,
is it really? Is it a shocking thing?
Because Deb, when we first got married, she's like, hey, just a heads up, I don't like Mexican food.
Yeah.
And I'm like, oh, really? And I'm like, well, what have you had? I'm like, well, my mom made tacos every once in a while. Yeah. I'm like, well, let's broaden our definition of Mexican food outside of the couple of times your mom made tacos.
So, it's kind of understood. If I say I don't like something, the next question is, have you tried it?
That's often what comes up.
You do support it. Because I've seen you bring this in your purse to the movie theater.
Yeah. When I make her smuggle a half gallon of whole milk into the movie theater.
Yeah, he said, we have to stop and get milk. Put it in your purse.
Put it in your purse like a dirty thief.
Yeah.
Well, thank you for that live voicemail, Kristen.
Mm-hmm.
It's not so often that something like that gets supported, so.
That was definitely for the good of the cause.
That's right. Mm-hmm. Just remember, there are dozens of us out there. Dozens of us!
With the same last name.
Yeah, that's right. Yes, I appreciated that.
I'm sure you did. That was, like I said, for the good of the cause.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Thank you,
dozens
Kristen.
Dozens of us.
Thank you, Kristen.
Yeah.
For that live voicemail. All right. Deb, our fall, much like the leaves falling gradually from the trees, we are to our last voicemail of our fall voicemails episode. So,
Is this our most beautiful one?
Sure.
It's orange.
I will explain after the voicemail why I feel like it is fall themed. But we will, much like sitting on a chair on your porch and watching the last leaf from your great oak fall to the ground.
Yes.
We will listen to this voicemail.
Hey, Deb and Luke, this is Liz. Mm. I'm sitting here watching my least favorite Disney movie.
Oh, no.
And I'll let you guess which one that is.
Mm.
But that made me think that maybe you guys should have a podcast episode sometime where you talk about things you hate.
Mm-hmm.
Like your least favorite of any certain category or many different categories. That sounds like a good idea. We want to know things that you hate, because it's kind of a distraction. If it something you hate suddenly bombards you, it's a distraction. So think about it. All right, bye-bye.
Just sounds like one big fun gripe session.
That's right.
I'm here for that. I think that would be really fun.
So, so I will say, in the fall spirit, I think there are some people, like, I don't know if both of us would say, probably both of us say fall is our favorite season, but I think there's a lot of people who are like, oh, it's so, like, we just have friends who are like, I hate being cold.
Yeah.
And just to, like, hear them. And so I would respond, thank you very much, Liz. And it's very possible that will at some time happen. But I would like to say, I've just appreciated that over the last year and whatever months that we've been doing My Darling's Distractions, in general, we tend to be a pretty positive podcast.
That's
like,
true.
That's kind of been like, hey, we could really rag on some things. And sometimes we do. Sometimes we do.
But it would be, don't you think that if we named some things that just kind of bothered us, things that we don't really like, that it would be really tame? Like we still wouldn't go like to the extreme, don't you think?
Yeah, we could, but there's just something I love so much about just like, just like genuinely enjoying something and like just not having, like following the old adage, if you don't have anything nice to say, don't make a podcast at all about it.
I think there's a way that we could do it that it would still be like funny and good. And so we'll table this conversation and come back to it.
Yes, we'll table that for another time. So that's,
I think
it's possible.
It would still be fun.
Possibly we will.
But what do you think is her least favorite Disney
movie? Yeah, and that's
movie.
What I wanted to hit up right before we left is least favorite. So so this is my guess is it's probably not going to be one of the main mainline, like your big heavy hitters. Also, I think it might have a number two or three at the end of it.
Oh,
that's my guess.
Well, okay, I'm going to disagree. I think it probably doesn't have a two or three at the end of it because I don't think it's worth mentioning if it has a two or three.
You don't even talk about it.
No, I think it's just, I don't think her boys would be watching it.
Because my guess was going to be like Cars 3.
Oh, well, maybe. When you say Cars, but I was thinking like Lion King 1.5 or 2. Sure. Like those aren't even worth mentioning.
Fair.
But I mean, I guess like Toy Story 2, like those definitely worth mentioning. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Or Finding Dory. Incredibles 2.
I liked Incredibles 2.
Yeah. But my guess is Pinocchio. Because it's
so
just
slow.
Weird.
Old and slow.
I mean, there's
so
some
Bambi. I mean, I don't want this to turn into a gripe session, but Bambi is slow too.
Yeah, yikes. But it's not like weird. Do you
sure.
know what I mean?
Sure, sure. Pinocchio is weird.
It is. Like, there's whole sections of that movie that I don't really remember. I think I've just, like, tuned it out because it's weird.
All those boys being carted off to the
donkeys,
island.
Donkeys.
Yeah,
they
the
become
island where
donkeys.
They slowly become donkeys
there's
because
alcohol
they're
involved
things. Yeah.
Or, like, smoking or something.
Yeah, I think they're it's just, like, a place where they just break things. Yeah, what a weird movie.
It's very strange. Yeah.
But anyway, my guess is Cars 3.
Okay.
And your guess is
Pinocchio. Pinocchio.
All right. Okay, Liz, let us know. We're all waiting in suspense for what your least favorite Disney movie is.
What's your least favorite Disney movie?
I don't think I have one. I don't think I want to do this. All right. Well, thank you, everyone, for sticking out through those voicemails. You voicemailers, you darlings, you distractors, thank you very much for the voicemails.
Thank you.
It is your energy and interaction with the show that keeps us literally going. So anyway, thank you very much for listening. I hope you've enjoyed it, and enjoy your fall time.
Enjoy the fall.
That's it. All right.
Thanks for listening. Oh. We'll talk to you later.
Okay, bye.
Bye.
Just now, you said you literally couldn't get out of bed. What? That really makes me want to literally.